Yes. And it sounds like it's going to be fun, energy-packed. It's going to be absolutely amazing. Tell me about the show.
The show is a two-hour show, and obviously it features Hannah Montana and Miley Cyrus.
Uh-huh.
I've got four dancers that are behind me and a five-piece live band.
Oh, wow.
We've got big three video screens that show videos throughout the whole thing, so no matter how fast you sit back or whatever, you can always see what's going on. Obviously, I sing all of her hit songs and dances, and all the costumes are pretty much exactly the same as hers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but it's really energetic, it's really crazy and fun, and yeah.
It sounds
great.
Like the kind of show that I want to be at. Yeah. Just in the back, in the back row, just be like, woo, woo. You know, not screaming too loud.
Come on, my shoes.
With one of those pairs of shoes. But you started performing at a very young age, two years old.
Yes, yeah, so I started dancing when I was two, started singing when I was five. And from there, just, worked my way up.
Weird how you say, like a South African.
I know, but yeah, I've been here for so long. I lived here for 6 months last year.
Yeah?
And I just keep saying, it's just like,
You suited. I could call you Anna Marie Venter right now.
Oh, yeah. That works as a stage name. Done.
Anna Marie, dames en heren, Anna Marie Venter, kan je dat geloven? But you left school at a very young age to pursue this career as a performer, as an artist.
Yes.
How did that come about? Your parents didn't force you into it, did they?
No.
I hope not.
Get to dancing.
Dance.
No, I left school when I was 16 or 17.
So maybe like 10th grade.
11th in Australia. I'm not quite sure how it works, but 11th in Australia, which is the year before I was meant to graduate anyway.
Okay.
It was a big decision, I guess, but I was pretty much just at school for the social thing because all I wanted to do was dance.
She was at the school for the social thing, not the
learning
thing.
I did my work.
Yeah.
No, but I was dancing before school and after school, and I would leave like some of my periods during school to go do singing lessons, and so it was just kind of like, you know what, I may as well go and study dance and singing full time.
Okay, so all our Miley Cyrus fans out there, please do not bunk school to go to singing lessons.
It was allowed.
Was it? Yeah. In South Africa, no, not allowed here.
And then I did that for 2 years, full time, Monday to Friday. And then I got an advanced diploma in musical theatre. So by the time everyone else had finished school, I'd already got my diploma. So it worked out.
Wow.
Yeah. So it wasn't like I left school and just danced,
and
you know?
Your parents were just okay with this?
Well, I had a qualification by the time I was meant to finish school. Whereas if I just finished school, you know, I'd finish school and they'd be like, so what now?
Wow, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
And now it's just snowballed into this awesome thing.
Crazy.
You're probably
career.
Living a life that's very similar to Miley Cyrus right now.
Well, yeah. You know, I've spent the last 2 years on tour pretty much. So living out of a suitcase, being on aeroplanes, and yeah, it's
five
awesome.
Five-star hotels, screaming fans.
Breakfast every morning.
I can see the marks in your arms from all scratching you. No, I'm joking. Makeup took that away. But do stick around with us. It's going to be a lot of fun today. You're definitely getting the best of both worlds. Miley Cyrus, Hannah Montana, plus Breakfast on Espresso and Good Hope FM all at the same time. She'll be performing for us later on as well. We'll be right back with your news after this break.